Hey there, I'm Tom, and thanks for joining me today. If you photograph portraits, you know how time-consuming retouching, especially skin retouching, can take, especially if you want professional results like this. This is a technique I developed way before frequency separation was even a thing. I'm a portrait photographer, and I also, at one point, retouched photographs for lots of other photographers, and I needed a way to quickly get exceptional results. So even though I developed this for Photoshop, it can be done in ON1 Photo Raw, and today I'm going to show you how to use two simple filters to achieve a look like this. Now, if you're a busy portrait photographer and you have lots of clients, I would still recommend my favorite program, Rebloom, because it has batch capabilities. So you get fantastic results with just a click of the button. This is the natural look. This is the fashion look. You could do this to one image. You could do this to 1,000 images. All automatically. But we're not talking about Rebloom today, although I do have a video on it and a 20% discount link below if you do want to take a look at it. Today is all about using ON1 Photo Raw and being able to take an image from here and with just two filters getting awesome results like this. So let's get to it. First off, I'm going up top and let's reset everything. So now we're back to the original image. Let's go into develop. With this image, I did photograph it in RAW and JPEG. My exposures were so good, I'm just using the JPEG files. So starting off in tone and color, I am just going to increase the brightness just about a third of a stop. We don't have to set a camera profile because that's baked into the JPEG file from the camera settings I was using. Also, I did a custom white balance before the shoot, so I don't have to adjust temperature or tint. So once the exposure is set, we are ready to retouch this image. We're going to go into effects by hitting the letter S. We're going to add a filter. And the first one is blur. So when you see this technique, it's not going to look great in the beginning, but it will come together by the time we finish up with the second filter. Under blur, we're going to go and right-click on the mask icon and invert the mask. We're going to hit the letter B for brush. I want the opacity to be 100. We can come up to opacity and use the slider, or we can do option 0. And that will change it to 100 as well. And in this case, we want to paint in. So this is the part where it is going to take a little bit of effort on our part. I'm using the bracket keys to make the cursor smaller, the brush smaller, and we're just going to paint over some of these blemishes. I'm going to grab the hand tool and move that and then hit the letter B again. So right now I'm just doing simple clicks over the areas. As you get used to it, you may even do a little bit more of a click, hold down the mouse and drag for some larger areas. But the main goal is to keep as much of the real skin texture there. So don't paint the entire face. just go over the areas that you want to improve. Okay, so that's looking really good. We can also change the opacity to 50%. So that's option Alt 5. And just to confirm, that's there. We're still painting in. And we can kind of go over some of these bigger areas. Or if there's bags, that's great to use at 50%. Sometimes shine is also something that I would do around 50%. So I'm clicking and dragging right now on those areas. And right now that's looking really nice. I might even go over some of this area here. Perfect. So that is what we've needed. We kind of created a mask. If we go over to the masking options and right click on it, we can hit show and see the different areas that we have retouched. I'm going to right click again, undo show. And this is the important part, right click and copy mask, because we want to use this mask on the next filter. So basically all we've done is blurred out the skin. So again, this part isn't looking great yet. I'm going to do Option Plus and we can kind of zoom in and you can see these areas. It's just blurred out. That would not be acceptable results for retouching. But here's the magic. We're going to go add a filter, and what we want to do is kind of create skin texture. And one of the easiest ways to do that is just with film grain. So we're going to click on film grain and we're going to select a film. And I'd like to start off with one of the bigger ones. It's going to be dependent on your camera, the size of the file, and the ISO you were shooting at. So some of the good choices to start off with is the Kodak T-Max 3200 or the Tri-X 400. I've also used Ilford, the HP 5400, and the Ilford Delta 3200. So play around with different ones. Today I'm going to use the T-Max 3200. So right off the bat, that's a huge improvement because it kind of covers those blurred areas. But it also is applying the film grain to the entire image. And that's not what we want. So all we have to do is go to the mask icon, right click, and paste the mask that we created when we were working on the blur filter. So now the noise is just going into that area that was blurred, and it's making it look like there's skin texture there. So that's how we went from here to here with amazing, beautiful results. So one thing you may have to change and play around with is the size of the grain, and you can kind of see how that is working there. And the amount or the opacity. You can kind of play around from 0 to 100, see where it looks best for you and your camera and your ISO setting. And also how much the face is taking up in the image. So all of these would be a lot lower if I was doing a family grouping and the faces were a lot smaller in the frame, and the grain is going to be bigger when it's a single subject close up. So is that amazing or what? Let's take it a step further so it's easy to do on the next portrait, and that's by creating a preset. So if you want to save the work here, that's a great time to hit check, because what we are going to do is we have to reset those masks. Even with the preset, you are going to have to manually paint on for each image. But it does make the process a little quicker by automatically applying the two filters and inverting the masks to give you a starting place. So on our two filters. I'm going to right click on the mask icons and select reset mask, and then right click and invert mask. Going to do the same thing for the blur layer. Right click, reset mask, right click, invert mask. Then we're going to go up top to settings and hit save settings as a preset. So there's a couple things that we want to make sure that we do right. Let's name it. We'll call this retouching or skin retouching. We want to uncheck develop because we don't want anything that we applied in the develop module to affect future ones, but we do want the effects. We want to make sure we hit the downward arrow and select apply mask. We want to select a category where we're going to save it. So I have one for all the presets I created, and we'll hit save. I already had one, but I'm going to override it with these new settings. So now let's go ahead and get rid of all the effect settings that we had. I'll show you how to use this new preset. I'm going to come down to the lower left corner and click on the icon to show and hide the left pane. You may have filters selected. I am going to make sure we're on presets. I'm going to navigate to where I saved it. Cheswick Photo, my custom presets. And I am going to select skin retouching. And with all of that, it didn't change the image at all. And that's actually exactly what we want. So to make room, I'm going to again close the left pane. And you'll see we have the two different filters there. So it's just a matter of going back to the blur, but we don't have to reset the mask. We don't have to invert it. It has all the settings there. And I'm going to hit letter B for brush, option 0 to have 100. Confirm that it is painting in, that it didn't default to erase again. And do what we did earlier. Again, probably speed this part up so you don't have to sit through it, but it's just a matter of going over. And this time I'm going to just be a little bit more sloppy. I'm gonna do a little bit more clicking and dragging just so you can see the difference. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. Let's go to option 5. So we're at 50% opacity on our brush. And again, I'm just going over, probably doing a little bit more skin than I did the first time, just so you can see if there are any real differences. Once we did the work on blur, we want to copy that mask. We want to go up to our film grain. The mask is already inverted because of the preset. And now we just want to paste the mask from the blur filter. And once again, pretty nice results, right? And that was being really aggressive with the painting part in the blur layer, not taking much time, not being as precise, and still get some really nice results. Another thing to remember, let's say you missed an area, something that doesn't look quite as good, you can always go back to the blur layer. Make sure you hit the letter B for brush, and I'm going to change the opacity back to 100, and I'm just going to kind of go over this one area. Okay, and once we have that, we have to add that change to the film layer. So copy the mask, go to the film, right click on that, paste the mask, and now you have the new and improved mask. So if you photograph portraits, be sure to try this technique out. I've used it for years. I've used it for weddings. I've used it for portraits. I've retouched images for other professional photographers, all with amazing results. I think this is my favorite method for quick skin retouching that gives you fantastic results. If you enjoyed today's video and this technique, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to my channel for future videos. Until next time, keep shooting.